Hi guys, today I'm going to do a Q&A. I like to keep doing these every now and then just because I like to have an open dialogue with you guys just in case you are curious about something or you just want to ask me something directly. I can answer any of you guys' questions. So if you ever want to ask me something, or the best way to reach me would probably be through my Instagram, my Twitter, or my Facebook, and that's where I asked you guys and that's where I'm getting all the questions from. So if you are a YouTuber and you don't have any of those social networks or you don't follow me on any of those, you can always leave your questions in the comments below and I will note them down, and that way when I do another Q&A video, I will answer those for you. So right now I'm just going to answer the questions that I already have from Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. So, and yeah, I just love doing these videos. I think it's so much fun. It's like you guys get to interview me, or you're like interviewing me, so it's really fun for me to do these types of videos. The first question comes from my friend Cindy. Her Instagram name is Clucid Dream, and she's asking, which eyeliner is your favorite and how long does it last? And that's really easy. It's the Makeup Geek eyeliner, and this is the one in Immortal. It is super black. It's a gel eyeliner. And it lasts a really, really long time. I mean, this is the type of eyeliner where I will wash my face several times and you will still see the eyeliner. It basically comes off only with makeup remover, not with just soap and water. So it's really potent and it's very strong. It lasts all day, it's super black. It is my very, very favorite liner. So this, you can get it on makeupgeek.com if you want to order it. It's only sold on the website, as far as I know. The next question is from basically Daniela. How did you start your YouTube channel? Like, what was your first video about? I really want to do my makeup and put it on YouTube, but I'm awkward and scared. Laugh out loud. Well, my favorite makeup brand is Sonia Kashuk, and it's only sold at Target. And whenever I would go on YouTube and look up makeup tutorials using Sonia Kashuk products, there was zero. Like, you would think that there would be at least a couple of people using her makeup products online, but there was nothing. So I decided that I wanted to do some makeup tutorials using her products because I really loved them and I thought they were so good that it needed to be shared with everybody. And also, just in case there was someone else out there like me that wanted to see some makeup tutorials using her products. So that's what I decided to do. That's why I decided to do YouTube, and my first video is a makeup tutorial using all Sonia Kashuk products. So it is a little bit awkward and scary at first, but it's just like with everything else, you just need to do it and get used to it, and eventually you just get comfortable being in front of the camera and it won't be such a big deal. The next question is from Carla Y. What is your favorite BB or CC cream? So I have three BB creams that I really like. The first one is from L'Oreal. This is the Magic Skin Beautifier BB Cream. I have the one in Fair. This is four beautifying actions in one. It primes, perfects, hydrates, and corrects. So I'll give you a little demo. It comes out like a white with some little grains in it. But then all you do is you rub it into your skin kind of like a lotion, and then it's going to change color. So you can see how it starts to change color, and then it'll match your skin. And what I like about this is that it has a really nice finish. It gives you really good coverage. It's buildable. So depending on if you have problematic skin, you can sheer it out if you want something more light, or you can build up the coverage if you need it. So I really like this one. I think it's really cool. And it just makes your skin look really flawless and matte, kind of like a matte finish. I also like the Flower BB Cream. This one is super potent. It has amazing coverage. This one is actually a little bit too light for me. This is BB1. So what I like to use this for is underneath my eyes for some highlight. But you can see there that it has really great coverage. It dries matte and it doesn't go anywhere. So that's this one. And if you want something that's just more lightweight, hydrating, and more of just kind of an everyday BB cream, I really like the Super BB Cream by Physicians Formula. This one is super hydrating. It gives you good coverage. Oops. So this is this one here. It glides on the skin. It feels really nice. And then it just improves your complexion. So this one's really lightweight. So those are the three that I really like to use. The next question is from Tanya. I hope I'm saying that right. What is the best lengthening mascara? Well, the one that I like a lot, and it's really expensive, but I still buy it because it works really well for me, is the Too Faced Better Than Sex Mascara. So this mascara lengthens my lashes as well as gives them volume. It has a really big brush and it's kind of a wet formula, but I really, really like it. It works so well that I keep buying it, and I'm really cheap, so that's saying something. If it's expensive and I keep buying it, that means it works. Another one that I've been using recently and it's been working really well is the Urban Decay Perversion one. So I do want to get the Submersion primer that goes with this before I actually do a review and actually give everyone a full review and see if it's worth buying, because this one's also kind of expensive. So keep a lookout for that one. This one is working really good on its own, so I want to see how it works with its primer. But yeah, that's my favorite mascara right now, is the Too Faced Better Than Sex. The next question is from Mar Ibrahim 90. Sorry, some of these I don't know how to say them. It is, what nationality are you and do you speak any other language? I'm Mexican and I do speak a little bit of Spanish. I'm not that good. There's a lot of words that I don't know how to say, so I can kind of just get by speaking Spanish, but I'm not that good. Marissa Forever 21 asked, what do you work as? I'm a stay-at-home mom and I do freelance makeup also on the side. Annie Flores asked, how does your hairstylist get your Provana hair color out? Like your blue, when you went from blue to purple. When I had my blue hair, it turned green with hair color remover. Please read this. I love you. I love you too, Annie Flores. Well, my stylist said that there is a Provana brand that will take out the color, so you have to get the, I don't know what it's called because I didn't see the packaging or anything, but Provana sells it and it is specifically to remove the Provana color. She did mention that you have to keep an eye on it because it will strip the color, but if you leave it too long, the color will go back into your hair. I don't know how it happens or why it happens, but you just have to keep an eye on it, and it works really fast. So when she put it on, it had, oh, and it smells really bad. It smells like rotten eggs. But you put it on your hair and it starts to remove the color. So I started to notice that my hair started turning really blonde. But all I know is that you have to keep an eye on it because the color will come back if you don't take it out in time. So I hope that helps. Niskaz, N-S-K-A-Z, I don't know how to pronounce that one, asks, what is your original hair color? The one that you were born with. It's really dark brown. Like, I don't know if you can see my roots. It's just a really like dark brown, almost black, but in the sun it kind of looks like it has red in it. So it's a really strange color because it's not red, but in the sun it has red undertones. So but like indoors it would look almost black. So that's my natural hair color. Bernice Anderson 1 asks, do you want any more children? And actually I get asked that a lot because I feel like since I have a girl and a boy, I have one of each, people automatically think that I'm done, like I don't want any more kids. But I actually do want more kids. I think I'll know when I'm done, like once I've had enough. But at this point in time, I still want to have more just because they're so cute and I just love my babies. Rebecca LG70 asks, how do you cover dark under eye circles? Well, I don't really have that big of an issue with my under eye dark circles, but I do know that if you have really bad under eye circles, then what you need to do is get a concealer that has a peach undertone, because that's going to cover up your dark circles, especially if they kind of look a little bit purple or on the blue side. You want a color that is going to counteract that. So you want to get a concealer that has like these peachy undertones. A really good one is by Pixi. This is the Correction Brightening Peach. So you can see that it has some peach undertones. And you want something that has really good coverage and it's a little bit creamy slash thick. So this one here, I'll kind of like demonstrate on my veins. I don't know if you can even see my veins, but here we go. So you just want to dab it underneath your eyes. You don't want to smear it because you want to give the best coverage. So you're just going to dab it underneath your eyes. And I don't know if you can see here how it covered up my vein. Hopefully that's showing up on camera. Hopefully it doesn't wash it out. But all you're going to do is put some of that underneath your eyes. You just want to dab it. And then you can go over it again, just tapping it with your foundation to blend everything out so that you don't see that this is a different color than your foundation. So I hope that helps. But that's basically what you want to do, is you just want to get a concealer with a peachy undertone, and then you're just going to dab it with a small amount, and you just dab it until you cover up the circles, and then you can go over it with foundation to make everything all one tone. And you're just going to dab the foundation on top as well. You don't want to smear it and then ruin everything that you just put on. So hopefully that helps you. If you still have any other questions, then go ahead and leave it in the comment below if I didn't answer your question correctly. NSKAZ also asked, what color are you thinking to dye your hair next? I really like the purple. I'm thinking of maybe adding streaks or maybe doing an ombre just to give it a little bit more dimension, because right now it's just one color, one solid color. But I'm thinking maybe I want to put some more different tones in it just so that it's not so boring. But I also really like soft lilac-y gray colors. I don't know. I will have to see, because usually I have to let my hair rest before I change the color and let it recuperate. But definitely something still within the purple family, but maybe just different tones within my hair. I think that would be really nice. Stephanie Claire Suarez asks, have you ever heard of ASMR? If not, could you look it up? Hearing you talk is so soothing to me. Thank you. I'm glad you like my voice and it doesn't sound annoying. ASMR. Let's see what Google tells me. Autonomic sensory meridian response is a neologism. Sorry, I'm so bad when it comes to like technical terms. I do not know how to say them. For a perceptual phenomenon characterized as a distinct pleasurable tingling sensation in the head, scalp, back, or peripheral regions of the body in response to visual, auditory, tactical, olfactory, and or cognitive stimuli. The nature and classification of the ASMR phenomenon is controversial, though there is a considerable cult following and strong Okay, next question is Shannon Fitz, next hair color. So something within the purple family, if not something like light gray. Lemon 80, or my friend Parisa, asked, tips for making money at home. Have you ever thought about starting your own makeup line? The way that I make makeup, the way that I make money at home is I do get a little bit of money from my YouTube channel. It's not very much, but whatever I do make, I just spend it on makeup, and so that I can continue doing reviews for you guys. Or I do make my little money on the side from doing makeup as well. So that's kind of like how I do it at home. And if I ever thought about starting my own makeup line, of course I would love to start my own makeup line. And I really like the whole thing about makeup. Like, I love the packaging, the actual product itself, the quality, the colors. I just love everything about it. So that would be a dream come true if I can have my own makeup line. Because who wouldn't want their own makeup line? I mean, you would have stuff that you yourself would love, like everything about. So yes. And as Kaz asked, are you planning to have any more children? And yes, I am. Tanya also asked, what is the easiest way to do winged eyeliner? The easiest way to do winged eyeliner for me is I like to start on the outer part of my eye. So like here, you can see I like to start here, and I like using gel eyeliner. To me, gel eyeliner is the easiest way to apply it. It's the cleanest, it's gonna look the best, and I like using an angled brush. So this one is a MAC 266, or you can get a MAC 263, I think it is. 263. One of them is synthetic and one of them is natural hairs. I think this is, which one is which? So the 263 looks like it's the synthetic, and the 266 looks like it's the natural hairs. I could be wrong. I can't really tell because they have product in them. But it's just basically an angled eyeliner brush, and I like to use these. And I like to start off at the very outer edge of my eye, and I always bring the liner from the bottom of my lower lash line and kind of continue it up towards the end of the brow. That's going to ensure that your eyeliner is both even, so you're not going to have one straight and one up. It's going to make sure that they're both going in the upward direction at the same angle. And you always want to lift your eye because that's the most flattering. It's going to like give you nice lift, and you don't want to look sad either. So I always like to start off at the very outer end of my eye, and then you just bring it up depending on how dramatic you want your liner. So you can just do a little baby wing, or you can do something too like really, really dramatic, like kind of how I have today, and bring it out further. And then I just like to make that line, and then I take the very tip and then I bring it down. So you kind of get an upside down triangle, and I kind of aim towards the middle of my lash line. And then you just fill it in, and then that's the easiest way to start out the wing. And then you kind of just bring the line in forward and just do small strokes. You don't want to do a continuous line like this, because then you can mess up very easily. So you just want to do little strokes and gradually build up the eyeliner. And then you always want your eyeliner to be the thickest on the outer part and then really thin on the inner portion of your eye. To me, that's the easiest way to do it. I do have a more in-depth video on how I do my eyeliner, and it is linked in the description box if you want to see that. But that's kind of a rundown of how I like to do my eyeliner. Anis Cuz also asked, what is the most complicated part about doing makeup in your opinion? To me, the most complicated part, or the hardest part, is figuring out how to make the skin look flawless. And this is as far as doing makeup on other clients. For me, it's the most challenging to make their skin look flawless and airbrushed, because if you can make a client's skin look awesome, then you already won like 70% of the battle. If you can make their skin look great, everything you do after that is going to just enhance their natural beauty and look really good. So to me, that is the hardest thing to figure out, making sure that you get the right color and that everything matches and that they don't look like they're wearing a mask. So to me, that is the most complicated part. For me personally, on myself, is just finding different techniques that work for me, because the way someone else does their makeup is not always going to translate on you. So you have to kind of tweak it and make it so that it's more flattering to your face or something that you like. So to me, that's the most complicated, but it's, to me, it's also fun. It's a challenge. She asked, Yvette D27 asked, how have you been married, or how long have you been married? I have been married 6 years. So I was married in 2008, so I've been married with my husband for 6 years now, which seems like a long time, but it doesn't feel like that. Jess Knows Best I was thinking of starting a YouTube channel. What's your best advice? My best advice would be, it depends on what type of videos you're gonna be doing. If you wanna do makeup tutorials, then I would invest in, if you're really serious about doing YouTube, I would invest in a good quality camera and good lighting. Because you are showing people how to do makeup and they wanna be able to see everything. And so think about the videos that you like to watch. I know personally that when I'm watching a makeup tutorial, I like good lighting and really good quality because I like to see every single thing. So if you're serious about doing YouTube videos and you really, really want to teach people and show them how to do makeup, then I would definitely invest in good lighting and a good camera and just always doing content that you yourself would want to watch and always be proud of your videos and, you know, because you're going to upload them and a lot of people are going to watch them. So always be proud of what you put up. Some of my earlier videos, now that I look back on them, they weren't really good quality. They weren't really easy to see, but I always at least did my very best and I did my very best makeup at the time. So I am still learning. But as long as you have really good lighting and high quality videos, then it should, people will come back to watch. Rochelle Rodriguez 31 asked, who is your favorite makeup artist? Right now, my favorite makeup artist is Jacqueline Hill on YouTube. I'm sure you guys have heard of her. She is my favorite makeup artist at the moment because I really, really love her techniques. I actually got the chance to see her in person at BeautyCon and I met her, and her makeup is absolutely flawless in person. I was just like wowed. I was blown away at how perfect it looked in person because, you know, sometimes you think, oh, they have really good lighting, so it could make it look better on camera than it does in person, like it could wash out some imperfections. But I actually saw her in person and her makeup was perfection. So she is definitely my favorite makeup artist at the moment. I really admire her talent and I really just want to be on her level. I'm just like, right now that is my goal. I'm like blending and blending and blending and blending because her makeup was just beautiful. And what I really like too is that she didn't look like she was wearing a mask, or like her makeup didn't look cakey. It just looked so pretty. I just loved everything about it. So she's definitely my favorite makeup artist at the moment. The next question comes from my sister, Lyda, from Facebook. She said, who inspired you to start doing makeup and who's your favorite makeup artist? So I already answered that one. That is Jacqueline Hill. She's my favorite makeup artist at the moment. And who inspired me would probably be just other makeup artists. I've always liked to do my makeup. I always enjoyed the whole transformation and just the confidence that it gave me. But just when I started to actually get better at doing makeup and I started improving on my techniques, so it inspired me to keep going and keep getting better and learning more. So that just really inspired me. There's a lot of makeup artists that I like. There's a lot of them that I follow on Instagram that inspire me every day just to do better. I'll kind of show you some of my favorites that I love. I love Laura Arellano. I think that's how you say it. She is Rihanna's makeup artist. So I don't know if you can see that. And she also founded or owns Melt Cosmetics, those lipsticks. So I really like following her. I like her makeup. I like Crispy. I like Desi's makeup. If you want to just check out my Instagram, you'll see that I'm following them. But I like Desi's makeup. I like everyone for different reasons. So I like Desi's makeup because her makeup is always really glowy. And she kind of reminds me, like the way she does her makeup kind of reminds me of Jennifer Lopez. So this is Desi. So I really like her skin. So I follow her. She has like that Jennifer Lopez glow. I really like Crispy. I like her makeup. I think she does really nice makeup as well. And I like her because I really like the way she does that cut crease and her brows and her eyeliner. So I follow a lot of different makeup artists for different reasons, things that I really like about them. Of course, Jaclyn Hill. So just other makeup artists really inspire me, and I just want to continue to learn and improve all my techniques. Alina from Facebook asks, what kind of job would you have liked besides being a mom and makeup? That's actually a really, really good question. If I wasn't a mom, or if I wasn't doing makeup, another hobby of mine that I really, really enjoy is cooking. I love to cook, I love to bake, I just love food. So if I wasn't doing any of this stuff, I would definitely go to culinary arts school. I would be some sort of chef or cook or work at a restaurant. And yeah, because I just love food. I love especially Japanese food. Japanese food is so good. I love Mexican food, of course. So I just love trying out new foods. And honestly, when I'm cooking, it relaxes me. I know that might be weird because some people get stressed out when they're cooking, but I actually enjoy the whole process. I like, you know, cutting up the vegetables, you know, doing the broth, doing sauces, cooking noodles, whatever it is, it just relaxes me. And then I always love eating the food at the end. And I think I just love the feeling. It's the same thing as makeup. I love the feeling of eating food and how I just feel so satisfied afterwards. So, and I like to give people things that I eat. Like when I make something, I'm like, do you want to try it? Do you want to try it? You know, especially if it's good, I just want to share that feeling with others. And that's probably why I like makeup so much too, is because I like to make other people feel better about themselves. My cousin Gabe asked me, do you miss me bunches yet? And of course I miss you. I wish you guys would just move to California already. So that is it for my Q&A video. Hopefully I answered all of you guys' questions. And again, if you have any other questions for me, you could always leave them in the comments below and I will get to them in my next video, because I do plan on doing these every now and then, just so you guys can get to know me better or ask me questions directly. I hope that this was helpful for you guys. And as always, thank you for visiting my channel, and I will see you in my next video.